Hello, everybody! This is Punk Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Super Mario Sunshine playthrough! Last time, we revisited Level 4, Peanut Park, to make a little more progress in that particular stage, and at the end of the last episode, we unlocked an old friend, our old dinosaur pal Yoshi, who made his first playable appearance in a 3D Mario game. And we're actually going to start off this episode with a sudden new development. Once again, we have to chase down Shadow Mario because it seems he's in possession of something else that we are going to have to retrieve from him. And it looks like this Shadow Mario pursuit is going to be a little bit more of a challenge than some of the others, because we're going to have to do some hardcore parkour if we want to take him down this time. He's actually gaining a pretty good distance on me. Been a while since I've done this particular Shadow Mario chase. There we go! Rats! And I was just about to turbo dash too! Alright, so we have actually unlocked a new attachment for our Flood. You got the turbo nozzle. Press and hold R to zoom! Alright, and we can actually take care of some stuff out in the overworld now. There are a couple of shine sprites that we can collect with the turbo nozzle. I don't believe I've actually demonstrated this before, but basically, hold down R and then Mario will rocket straight ahead at a high rate of speed. This will allow us to get past certain obstacles in order to get objects such as shine sprites. However, the downside to the turbo nozzle is that you pretty much have to go forward. You know, if you try to change your direction, it can be a little difficult trying to maneuver. There are a couple of shine sprites I could grab right off the bat with this attachment, but we're going to hold off on that because I am actually going to... what we're actually going to do in this episode is we are actually going to begin a new level. In the last episode, when we unlocked Yoshi, we actually removed a large pineapple blocking a large red pipe on one of the rooftops. This pipe right here. This is the entrance to level 5. Let's go ahead and get started. It's level 5, Sirena Beach, and episode 1 is going to be the Manta Storm. There's a storm coming, y'all! Oh dear. Quite a mess. Something tells me that that goop is not supposed to be there. Anyway, when you start the stage, break open that crate that I just ground pounded and you will... That will pretty much always give you an extra life. So, take advantage of that 1-up whenever you can at the start of this level. But it seems like we have a more immediate problem to take care of, and these Piantas don't seem too pleased. What? The hotel's vanished? What does that mean? Hey, what's going on? What's this nonsense? You, fix it, now! Okay, lady. I guess nothing to do but talk to this guy. Oh, please tell me my nightmare is over. You can save me. I don't know why, but you just look very capable to me. Listen, it all started around noon. This giant manta-shaped thing showed up. It was this paper-thin floating silhouette. It came and covered the hotel grounds in this electric goop. Then, oh the horror, my beautiful hotel, my poor building. It sank in the middle of that awful ooze. Why me? Why? Now I've got the staff cleaning up, but where's my hotel? What am I supposed to do? I can't just sit back and... Ah! It's back! That gossamer ghoul! DO SOMETHING! Oh, hello! What a way to start this level, huh? A boss battle! This is the Phantom Manta! And this can be a pretty long and drawn-out fight. Because, as Flood here demonstrates, you simply have to spray the creature with water. However, spraying it with water will cause it to split. From the initial giant manta, it'll split into two. And then those two mantas will split into... I believe they will subsequently split into four. And basically, each manta you break apart will split into four progressively more and more until ultimately, they'll split up so much, you will have 84 of these phantom mantas coming after you. So this can be a potentially very long and drawn out fight. And I'm actually considering splitting the part and editing out most of this fight until I get down to the final stage where it's all the, all the smaller mantas trying to come after me. Ouch, and do your best not to touch the goop, because this goop is electrified and it will take off one segment of your health bar each time you make contact with it. So yeah, I may just edit out most of this fight, because this fight can take a long time, and it can be tedious. And I don't want you folks to have to just sit through all of it, so... I'll see you in probably... well, thanks to post-production, I'll see you in probably 2 seconds. Alright, here we go. Now at this point, once you've split all the larger mantas into the smaller mantas, they will basically go into this berserk type state, and they will all begin to home in on your position. But this actually works in our favor, because in most of the footage that most likely I will have cut out by this point, basically, the mantas just go whatever direction they want initially, and you're going to have to chase them down all over the place, clearing a path through all this electric goop in the process. So this may actually benefit us now that they're trying to actually come after me. Still gotta take care not to, come into contact with them, because they'll knock you around. And much like the electric goop they leave behind, physical contact with these little guys will deal one segment of health. So this is basically what you just have to do. You just have to make them come, let them come to you, and then just, use your hover nozzle, and you'll be mostly out of their way, and you can just rain death from above. But it's a lot of little mantas you gotta clear out. Like I said, ultimately it's 84 of these. It can be a total of 84 of these little guys. And they all want our blood, apparently. I'm not that concerned about the damage I'm taking, because I did make a point to leave behind a few of the gold coins that are scattered throughout this resort area, so... I'd rather not take the hits at period, but I'm getting knocked around, oh my god. I may have spoken too soon. We get to the little cabana over here, we can refill our health. Alright. I gotta lure these guys away. But they've really made this hard for me, because there is so much goop. There's not really a safe passage. That's really, this fight isn't really difficult. The problem is, the thing that's gonna be an issue is just the goop that these guys leave behind and just the sheer number, you know. I mean, there's, you know, this, you know, the phrase strength in numbers, and this boss fight pretty much embodies that old saying. But I think we just cleared him out. There's Hotel Delfino. Woo! Fantastic! You're amazing! You're my hero! I was just flapping my gums about getting rid of that thing. I didn't believe you'd actually do it. Never doubt Mario. Woo! Let's get out of here! Our first shine of Serena Beach, but we definitely had to work for it. But like I was trying to say, the boss itself isn't necessarily difficult. It's just, it can take a while, especially in the initial stage, when you're at first having to chase around all the mantas as you make them split up. The difficulty really comes from the goop they leave around and their sheer numbers. And it looks like we got another Shadow Mario chase this time around. But looking at that nozzle, that's actually a nozzle that we've used before. But now we're actually going to be able to unlock it so we can use it anytime we wish. Just gotta listen for Shadow Mario's music, and the chase is on once again. But I win in the end, of course. Shoot! And I was just about to rocket jump, too! Denied. You got the rocket nozzle. Power up with R and blast off! So here's the other unlockable flood attachment, the rocket nozzle. While the turbo nozzle is utilized to launch yourself forward, with the rocket nozzle, it's all about up, up, and away. And I will gladly demonstrate this with this seemingly random little object. Let's launch ourselves up into the air and boom! That's a fun thing you can do with the rocket nozzle. Launch yourself high into the air, and you can initiate a super ground pound. We can also add another shine to our collection. Another thing about the rocket nozzle is that if you jump just before you launch, you'll get extra height. So that's something else to keep in mind as well. But the main focus of this episode is, once again, Serena Beach, our newly unlocked level. We've already got one shine sprite out of that level, although it took way too long, in my opinion. I'm probably going to be cutting out at least 7 minutes of footage. But let's continue. It's off to Serena Beach, Episode 2. The Hotel Lobby Secret. You know what that means when that word is in a level title. I'm going to admit, I'm not the biggest fan of some of the shine objectives here in Serena Beach. This is not a level I typically go back to on my own free will very often, but I have to give the level credit for the outside area. I love the music and just the atmosphere of this, you know, just something about a beach at sunset, you know. I mean, this is a very nice visual, in my opinion. Just great, very atmospheric, very moody. And like I said, you know, if I've said it a few times already. If they were to make an HD remaster of this, like, they really should. They really should make an HD remaster of this game. I would totally buy it. It would look so good. All right, buddy. Hey, it's Mario, right? Yeah, Mario. Listen, I have a feeling you can help me out again. See, the hotel, it's full of ghosts. So, well, could you maybe... Look, just come inside, please. I can tell you're a miracle worker. Don't be so modest. Alright, our first glimpse into the lobby of Hotel Delfino, and he wasn't kidding! Yes, the familiar old boos make their first appearance in this game. And we have regular boos, and we have pink boos. The pink boos are going to be our primary concern, because we have this large totem pole type object in the center of the lobby, and we actually need to get to the top of this thing in order to, do what we need to do. At the top of this totem pole is a boo statue, and we're gonna need to get inside this thing's mouth. And I think you know where this is headed. Yep, it's one of those missions. And this is one of my least favorite secret levels, specifically for one particular segment that I never fail to die on. We also get our first look at the strolling stew type enemies. Those guys are basically the replacements of the Goombas, you know, the standard enemies that just walk around and you can just jump on them. So you could say in Super Mario Sunshine, instead of doing a Goomba stomp, we're doing a stew stomp. Hey there, nice alliteration. Alright, so honestly, a lot of this level isn't so bad, but there is just the one specific segment I alluded to earlier, and we are steadily approaching said segment. Okay, move quickly along these sandy blocks. We've encountered these before. They will fall away as you stand on them. And looks like I'm gonna have to pound this watermelon segment. I swear, these stages get weird. Like, what's with the watermelon platforms? Alright, this is the worst part right here. This cog. Gotta be very attentive during this part. Gotta pay very close attention. Be careful with your movements, obviously. This is going too well. I'm suspicious. At the end, oh my gosh. On the first try, it's the reverse recorder's curse. I was expecting to fail that at least three times. Hey, that's less content I need to cut out. I'll take that. I'll take a successful first run any day. Now comes episode 3, Mysterious Hotel Delfino. This level's gonna be much more in-depth than the previous two. And the previous two were pretty damn in-depth, especially the first one. Okay, let's just not waste any time, because this one's actually going to require us to really explore Hotel Delfino pretty much up and down. So we're going to have to talk to the owner here once again. Ah, dear Mario, please come right in. Do I sense some reluctance? Come now, don't dawdle. Better voice acting that's actually in this game. Okay. So the first object of interest is going to be this Yoshi egg. This Yoshi wants a pineapple or else he will not hatch. Unfortunately, the fruit stand here does not have pineapple stocked. Now, this is not a level, this is not a mission I'm a particular fan of, because it can actually take a while if you don't know what you're doing. And even if you know exactly what to do, it can still take a while. Anyway, the first thing you want to do is head into this bathroom, and you want to jump up where there's water running. And now let's see if I can actually get on the path here. Wow, bad camera angle on that one. I get a really creepy vibe from this weird painting. But you want to know what I find even creepier than that? Imagining how you got in here! Okay, so basically this is a long sequence of like puzzles and things of that nature. First we need to spray this picture and it'll form the image of a boot. Jump on through and we will be taken to the next part. Ouch, which is populated by booze. Okay, spin this. Okay, now we need to spray these spinning doors. This will also form the image of a boo. Get used to the boo motif in this level. It is prevalent through pretty much every single mission. And okay, I just need to get this last panel to flip. This isn't the last time we're going to be flipping panels in this level either. There we go, okay. Next, spray these pink boos. I'm basically trying to go from memory here, and my memory of this mission is a bit fuzzy. But hopefully I can figure things out. Okay, next we spray this. Alrighty then, you got something to say? Now where did I put that thing? Hey, have you seen a pineapple anywhere around here? Pineapple, you say? Well, if we spray this poster, that'll open something up. All right. Notice how this coin here is not spinning, but these are. If they're rotating, it's a genuine golden coin. If it's not rotating, it's a boo. You can also get a blue coin from this particular room. Alright, I guess I can go ahead and point this out while I'm trying to figure out what I need to do. That shine sprite in there is our goal, in that swimming pool area. Unfortunately, if we try to take the direct approach and go in through the door, that Pianta standing at the doorway will not allow us in because we don't have a bathing suit. Aha! Luckily, I believe this bedroom, right, that hotel room is the key to our... to where we need to go next. Now, as you're going around here in the attic, you'll find these large sleeping boos blocking the pathway. We're going to need Yoshi in order to clear a pathway, because believe it or not, Yoshi can actually eat these boos. Unfortunately, because we don't have Yoshi at the current time, we're going to have to take a few alternate routes in order to ultimately get to where we need to go. This may involve a little bit of trial and error, this process here, because we have some cracked floors here in the attic which we can ground pound in order to drop down to a lower level. The problem is, I don't exactly remember which cracked floor leads to where. Like I said, I don't play this level all that often. But it seems like... no, that wasn't it. Definitely going to be some trial and error in editing in this episode. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, after getting turned around, I managed to remember what I needed to do. We actually need to ground pound this tile. And if we drop down here... let's see, I believe if we break one of these, we can get ourselves a pineapple! Ha ha! So, we got ourselves what we needed to get. Now that we got the food that Yoshi wants to eat, we can actually utilize our dinosaur friend. And maybe now we can actually begin to make progress here, because you are pretty much stymied until you actually get Yoshi, so you can actually accomplish stuff. So now we can go back up to the attic, and I think at this point, this is when you're actually supposed to even go up here to begin with. So Yoshi here apparently has a taste for ghosts, if you can believe it. I mean, I knew Yoshi was, you know, had quite the appetite, but ghosts? Never thought I'd see that. But in any event, let's go ahead and clear a pathway. And there are other parts of the floor. There are other cracked floors which we can ground pound and break through. But I'm not really sure if I'm going to do that. I think I'm going to cut to the chase because there is one specific floor tile here in the attic that we have to break in order to... what's going on? Don't tell me I can't get back on Yoshi. Really? What am I supposed to do now? There we go! I don't know what the hell was going on there. It was like I got knocked off of Yoshi by the sleeping Boo, and I guess Yoshi was still... I guess when I was trying to get back on Yoshi, I was making contact with the hitbox of the Boo? That was really odd. Anyway, we can actually drop back down to here, clear out that sleeping Boo, and get ourselves a blue coin. All right, back to the attic. All right, I finally managed to get back up here in this damn attic. Man, the problem I was running into is that unfortunately, when you're riding Yoshi in the Hotel Delfino, you actually cannot open doors because I don't know reasons. So I had to screw around and try to get like this spin jump down so I could actually get back up to the upper floors and stuff. But I think at this point I don't actually need Yoshi, so I think I can go straight for the prize, which is the Shine Sprite. I just have to figure out where it is that I need to go exactly. Alright, think I found the right place. Let's drop in! Ah, there it is! Hey you! No one in the pool without proper swimwear! Sorry, buddy! Your shine is mine! God, that took forever. I'm gonna be cutting out at least 10 minutes of footage on that one. I hate that mission. It takes me so long to get it done. Because there's always that one step or two that for some reason I just cannot internalize. Like, I just can't retain it. Alright, but I'm still gonna keep going here. But this is going to be the last shine I'm going after for this episode. It's time for Sirena Beach, Episode 4, The Secret of Casino Delfino. Hey, that rhymes. I get it, game. It's set inside the Hotel Delfino. It's a nice looking hotel, but you don't need to beat me over the head with it. I have a feeling I might need that one-up. But once again, it's time to make our way inside the luxurious confines of Hotel Delfino. Well now, Mario, you really should drop by the casino. I'll let my boys know you're coming. Go on now! I'm not the gambling type, but I'll drop in and have some fun. Ah, Mario! Right this way, please! Alright, so we've actually got ourselves a little sub-area. Welcome to Casino Delfino. We got some slot machines here that we can mess around with, so let's have a little bit of fun. Okay, all I'm getting is duds. I'm not even going to worry about this. But there is something we have to... Now that I'm looking at it, now I remember. There is something we have to do with the slot machines. And I think you do have to line up 3 sevens. But this is actually the slot machine in which you want to attempt this. Because, each individual slot is going to spin. You jackass. Can't you see I'm trying to win the jackpot here? Alright. 3 sevens, baby! There was a point to doing that. If I'm correct. Ah, the jumbo slots. Well, 777s is obviously the best you can do. I've yet to see anyone get 777s on both slots. Oh, it's coming back to me now. Ah, you do have to do both slots. Now that I'm starting to really think about it. Like I said earlier in this recording, this is not a level I come back to very often. So my memory of some of the challenges is limited at best. Oh look, another ghost for me to jump on. This is gonna be a pain in the ass. As I say that, I land the 777. Okay, but now comes a part that is a genuine pain in the ass. I made a reference to this earlier when earlier we were having to flip some panels. We gotta flip all 16 panels on this mural to create the image of a shine. However, the problem is that these flipping panels are very sensitive to your water as you're spraying them. And sometimes you'll unintentionally hit a panel that's already been flipped and you'll have to reflip it and you can end up hitting the other panels in the process. There we go! Woo! Okay. We're moving along nicely. Moving along nicely. Now, you know what's probably coming. Another one of these levels, ladies and gentlemen. Right. So we got the giant moving cubes this time around, and these cubes have no problem pushing you around and pushing you off the stage to your doom. So you're going to have to watch the movement patterns of these large cubes in order to find an opening so that you can safely get across each segment in order to actually get through the stage. So let's see if I can safely navigate. And some of these cubes will press up against each other, so I'm assuming there's a possibility of being crushed. So, don't want that happening, obviously. Oh dear, okay. Now we got this rotating cube. We're gonna have to follow its motion in order to stay on. Now we got these platforms moving in and out of slots in the wall. Or you can utterly fail to jump. I hate it when that happens. Alright, let's try this again. And this time I will actually jump. Almost there. Ah, one of these rotating platforms. I remember these from that one secret stage in Rico Harbor. Bad memories. Bad memories. Okay. Now this one's gonna be moving in an unusual motion. But if we can just make the jump, yes! Hells yeah! Uh-huh. Who's the man? Now I'm all cocky. Whew! And the raw footage of this recording at this moment is approaching 55 minutes. I'm gonna be doing some work to edit this video down for upload, but nonetheless, that is going to do it for what is ultimately quite the productive episode of the Super Mario Sunshine playthrough. We have begun a new level, Serena Beach, and managed to collect 4 Shine Sprites out of that stage. We've also unlocked the 2 additional nozzle attachments for Flood. So that's going to wrap up a very productive episode of this playthrough. And if you folks liked what you saw here, be sure to like the video, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.